Look. Listen. With the other lions, huh? Is he talking to them? Not listening to you? Oh. Oh, baby. Mom's probably hungry. But the baby shouldn't be out like this. This is a really, truly, truly incredible moment. I think, let's just watch this little cup for another few seconds just to see if it does go back down into the leather. I'm not sure where its mum's gone. Nancy, there's part of me that wonders if maybe she isn't missing one of her cubs, and perhaps she's looking for it. Oh, it might just also be that she's a young mom. Oh, not a young mom, she's a new mom with young babies. And she's tired. She needs a bit of a break. That could also be. It might be she's hiding in the bushes close by, listening to it, making sure it's safe, watching over it. She wasn't far when we saw her earlier. But this thing is crazy. Cub is hung around long enough. I think perhaps if we go back to it. He is indeed declaring himself the king of the Mara. Welcome, little one, to your new world. Not an easy one. Okay. Alice, I think this might be our opportunity. Be a really good opportunity for that to get the audiences of social media. Hello to those of you that have just joined us, and welcome to the most incredible scene I think I've ever witnessed in all my time following lions. In the few months that I've been here in the Masai Mara, we are coming to you live with this amazing little tiny lion cub screeching for mum, desperate to get her attention. And you are watching this live in the Masai Mara as this little tiny fragile creature wobbles its way out of its den site and leaves us with questioning. Oh, just listen to this. You're making such a noise. Wobbles its way out of the drainage line and leaves us all wondering what on earth Mom is thinking. Now this little cub is only, I would say, now looking at it, maybe about 2 weeks old, if that. Julie, you say such tiny little roars. I know. They are utterly adorable. Mum is roaring somewhere just off in the bushes up at the top there. There is another lion coming up behind me. In fact, I think it's going to slink right past us at some point. She's been roaring as well. And this little one's been chewing. desperately to know. But what is confusing me tremendously, I know it's him for now, but we're just going to wait patiently. What's confusing me is why Mum came down, called it out, and then promptly didn't stay to stick around long enough to feed it. Megan, absolutely go back to the den, little one. Don't sit there yelling. It's the night time here in the Maasai Mara. We're sitting in pitch black with just the moon and our infrared lights to guide us. So we're not in any way shining any lights on this little cub, and we are very far away from it. But yowling like that could so easily draw the wrong sort of attention. Yes, Mum could come back, but at the same time, hyena, anything like that will be attracted to that sound. But why isn't Mum coming back? Just waiting to see or not. Mum is going to come back to it. Oh, look at it. You can see just how very, very tiny it is. Laura, you want to know when the eyes open? Laura, it's around about at the earliest 3 days after they're born, and it can take up to 10 days after their birth. They're also born with their tiny little ears flat to their skulls, which is why I think this cub is around about 2 weeks. Its ears have started to pop up. But it's got such a big voice for such a little thing. Come on, Mum. What a hungry little one there. No, that's a bush. You can't walk through there. Even as tiny as you are. Oh, I can hear her calling. I can hear her now. Ferocious horse, little one. Did yourself proud. Listening to Mum's calling as well. Now, it might just be that this little cub is misbehaving. It might be that Mum popped past to check on her cubs. The others might be sleeping. But on average, lionesses will have between 2 to 3 cubs. So it's unlikely that this one's on its own. Love is a thing, and Mom has got to feed herself. Is that Mom? Hey! Mom! There she is, well spotted on Manu's behalf. Mom, you have got a yowling little cub down there. I think it would really like a meal. I think she's just having a break, folks. I really do. If she's this close to the cub, I thought she'd moved off, but if she's this close to the cub, we actually have nothing to worry about. That mother will not let anything get anywhere near the tiny bundle of fluff that's vanished. Where on earth have you gone? Right, it's just been the most phenomenal evening. Let's go back over to James, who is on the other side of the Mara River, and he's also got tiny little ones.